Finally tonight, another in our occasional series on poets and poetry. Rae Armantrout won the 2010 Pulitzer Prize in Poetry for the collection Versed. Her latest book, Money Shot, was published last year and deals in part with the financial crisis.
Complex systems can arise from simple rules.
My name is Rae Armantrout. I live in San Diego. I grew up in San Diego, actually. I teach at UC San Diego, but mainly I'm a poet. My poetry always includes whatever's around me. If I watch something on television, if I hear the news in the car, if I hear certain phrases being bandied about, or if I see things happening to my friends, like a couple of my friends have lost their homes in this financial debacle. Of course, that's going to get into my work. And what I like to do really is to write about the intersection of the public and the private, or what's left of the private in our lives, and to kind of bring those aspects of reality together.
Money talks. Money is talking to itself again in this season's bondage and safari look, its closeout camouflage. Hit the refresh button, and this is what you get. Money pretending that its hands are tied. On a billboard by the 880, money admonishes, shut up and play.
In the poem Bubble Wrap, which is the one that I wrote on the day that the stock market lost so much of its value, I was coming home from the store and I actually saw this immigrant who was selling, or trying to sell, no one was actually approaching him, these scorpions made of what looked like twisted electrical wire. And I had the thought, well, you know, this is going to be the new economy now. It seems like if value can suddenly disappear that way, then what kind of value was it? It's a sort of magic value, you know, that they can create out of nothing and then it can disappear. So I was listening to the language that they use to talk about the crisis. I mean, terms like credit default swap and leveraged buyout. And although the whole thing was horrifying, as a poet and as someone who's interested in language, I couldn't help but be fascinated by those terms.
Now an engine's single indrawn breath, the black hole at the heart of it is taking it all back. An immigrant sells scorpions of twisted electrical wire in front of the Rite Aid.
There's a lot of the San Diego landscape in my poems. There are a lot of palm trees and junipers, and just the flora of San Diego comes in constantly. That one of the poems, Long Green, would possibly in some sense be a pastoral poem. It's about plants. There are, you know, various kinds of plants mentioned in it. But the language of the financial crisis kind of creeps in and becomes integrated with the language about nature.
Long Green. Such naked spines and vertebrae, convincing parallels, upright, separated by a few inches of clay. Such earnest green gentlemen, such stalwarts jouncing in the intermittent wind. Idea laundering exists primarily to produce a state of equilibrium. All night the sea coughs up green strands, cold boluses, and swallows them back in.